Let us continue the killings.
Making is out in the city, but I'll explain.
Well, hello there, Anselm.
So I knew plenty of people like Paolo growing up. Maybe not as crafty. I need to know why Delilah can't be killed. Everything we've learned implies that something strange happened at Aramis Stilton's home 3 years ago, but then he disappeared.
Stilton lived in a bunker kept secure by a fancy lock made by Jindosh. Maybe inside you'll learn more about how to stop Delilah.
But I have to get there first through a ruin created by the Duke, where I used to live.
Megan had an intriguing idea. Paolo is leader of the Howlers. He wants Vice Overseer Byrne killed. And of course, Byrne wants Paolo dead too. Both groups will attack you on sight, but walk in with the corpse of their chief enemy, and they'll treat you like family.
So that gives me at least one way into Aramis Stilton's house.
I'm pretty sure that will work.
Coming back here, seeing it changed, run into the ground. Some people have reached beyond others. The old Batista neighborhoods, full of mining families, called the Dust District now. If I put people to work down in a mine, I'd want to live in a fortified bunker too.
Yeah.
What's that?
That was me.
Ready now?
Not just yet.
My old bones can only take so much waiting.
Let's go.
Get you as close as I can.
I didn't know Aramis Stilton. Who was he?
Loyal to the old Duke. Stilton helped build modern Karnaca with those silver mines. Worked his way up from nothing to a fortified mansion. But the new Duke spends money so fast. The mine crews work all day and all night. The district's in ruins. The dust drives out anyone except the most desperate.
The Duke of Cirkonos has made a mess of things. His father was a good man.
True, but the new Duke's misery is only being possible with Dunwall's support. In any case, you'll have to pass through the Dust District. Maybe Stilton's still in there, or maybe he's dead. Find Megan once you reach the Dust District. She'll tell you more. I'll wait here with this skiff and take you back to the dreadful
wave
after you finish.
Oh, and bug down a little bit, okay? The button is not pressed. Yeah, when I click tab, it starts going to the right. Why?
It was never meant to be this way.
what the hell is going on? Got fixed. Whatever the fuck it was.
Soldiers blinded by that hallucinogenic powder the Howlers use, then stabbed to death or dragged down by the Abbey's guards. One young lieutenant got hit by an overseer grenade.
Alert, and I says I am alert. I've been alert.
That won't happen until someone manages to kill either Paolo or Vice Overseer Byrne. And I don't see you or me beating a path to the Crone's hand, or up to the temporary stronghold the Abbey's got set up.
Silver dust out of my ears. I think I spotted some.
What the bastard, void monster?
What the?
Oh, there's a problem. Sometimes you don't even see them.
No one here.
Someone's gotta give.
It's getting so one can't even breathe no more.
The whole family stung to death. So disfigured. Blood flying mess all around them. Horrible. just have to finish my shift. Then I can go home.
Tasted awful. That weren't no blue-jawed hagfish. River crust is more likely.
There you go. There was an actual entrance. Nice. Yeah, you basically can't play the game fully stealth without killing anyone. As far as I remember, you can avoid killing the bosses also. I may try that, but I have no real incentive doing so. But if I did have an incentive,
Reconnaissance, talking to people. The overseers and the howlers have divided up the district. Just ahead is neutral territory where no one will harass you. But further on, the howlers and the overseers both have boundaries set up. And beyond those points, they'll attack you on sight.
Aramis Stilton is the real goal. Sokolov said you'd worked out a plan.
Yes. I believe that if you take out Paolo or Vice Overseer Byrne, the other one will grant you safe passage, and will help you get inside Stilton's home. Neutralize either one of them, and bring him to the other.
Got anything else?
Byrne is protected by the Overseers. Paolo has the Howlers, but I think he's also got some kind of black magic charm. They say he's got to die twice before the sun sets, or he can't be killed. Good luck with that.
I'm gonna kill them both. I mean, there's no real reason why not to do so, and I'll just force my way through to the where I'm supposed to go.
Where that our silver mines are operating past full capacity in order to Maybe another time.
Or not. Let's go.
The woman sat in a row. They all wore different colors. And Dr. Mercola wore a jaunty red hat. And then with the far left. Countess Conti. Or on my next to the guest. Wearing a blue jacket. Eh? In purple side with someone in white. And remember the purple because the woman spilled her wine all over. General Ferdomo was dressed entirely in green. I don't think I'm nowhere near smart enough to do this, but I'm sending around in different colors. You press out the left or somewhere in the way. Like, I need more information, I would suppose. Okay, let's leave it at that for now.